Good morning and welcome to your monthly reading, my dear Cancer. Even true that this is for July, you can see this whenever it comes to you. My readings are always timeless. Always take what resonates from my readings. Flip the roles. You can be male, you can be female. You can have Cancer wherever in your chart. You can be dealing with a Cancer. Check out your other signs and your North Node because there is more information for you. As I have mentioned in the bigger reading I did for July, I will link it up here. We have Mercury in Cancer this month from the 11th to the 27th. Your words are going to be smoothly. They're going to be very flowing. They're going to bring a lot of peace, a lot of love, a lot of harmony. They're going to just run like honey. There is the sweetness. And you can use this for your advantage because people will understand you clearly. People will follow your lead. If you want something from someone, they probably will give it to you. So really use this opportunity for yourself. Say what you want. Say what comes from your heart. Obviously, with all energies, and especially with the Mercury energy, don't be sharp. Don't be negative. Just be smoothly. You don't need to rush anything. You don't need to be, harsh. But it's simply just a perfect opportunity for you to really say what is on your mind or your heart, basically. Because our words and our love should come from the heart. If you like someone, tell them. If you don't like someone, obviously also tell them. There might be a Taurus or a Libra in your life. This can be someone that you're telling the truth to. It can also be something around love. It can be both ways. It can be a friendship. It can be a business. It can be business matter. But there might be or might come a Taurus or a Libra into your life. So you might also, you know, vice versa, have someone who is telling you a lot of beautiful honey flowing words and things. There's a lot of love around you. But keep away from the paranoid and the jealous words because it's not going to do you any good. Another thing that I pick up on is that for someone out there, there might be someone that you like who is pulling back a little bit. The message for you is to let them be. Someone here is trying to figure out something. Building up the courage to be truthful to you about their situation. So just be calm if that is the case for you. But all in all, it's a very positive energy for you. There is a lot of love. There's new friendships coming into your life, business partners, soulmates. You have this courage. You have this peace. There's so much peace around you. Work on self-love, on your worthiness. You are enough with your whole entire being. You're doing things exactly as you're supposed to do. Before that we continue, I am just going to change the battery and then I will be back. All right, we are back. Let's jump into the first card. Jupiter Abundance. Oh, yeah. Here we go. Let's just take all the cards. And let's see. And then we are going to go into details. The wind. What is the wind bringing you? Well, a lot of peace, a lot of warmness, a lot of signs. And the octopus, water element, very well fitting for you. So you might have a lot of new ideas, a lot of things around you. It's very important that you stay calm. Yeah, very, very important that you stay calm. Stay balanced with your emotions, because one thing that can bring you out of balance, out of focus, is your emotions. There is a lot of change in luck for you. Suddenly things are just going to go very, very well for you. And you almost get to the point where you don't believe it because that it's so obvious that you are followed by luck. Don't give up and don't be pessimistic about it. Don't doubt it because it's real. You have high ideas, your standards are high. You have this sense of purpose. Wow. You have the strength to really go for it. It's so badass, such a badass energy. You have wanted to see the meaning behind life, the meaning behind your life purpose, and it's here. Some of you guys already feel this energy. Some of you guys will the next days, the next weeks, throughout this month. You might be drawn to teaching in a way. It can be different ways. It can be school, it can be spiritual, it can be networking, just being a part of other people's practices. Pay attention to the color purple in your life. I feel that is a good sign for you that you're on the right track. You are on your way, yeah. Don't neglect yourself. Don't neglect your wishes and your dreams, your hunger for this purpose. There is a very lucky break coming for you here, breakthrough. But you might be required to step out of your comfort zone. If you feel pushed to do something that you are, well, uncomfortable is not the right word, but that you feel worried about. Because there is this idea of, am I good enough for that? Can I do this? You are. It is for you to really step into what you wish for. So pay attention to everything, Cancer, because, wow, again, whoever you are, no matter where you have Cancer in your chart, it could be in your midheaven, it could be linked together with your career, it could be in your Juno, it can be your North Node, rising, moon. But you're opening up to a lot of more possibilities for yourself that attracts more. Everything pays off now. If this card of Jupiter, of abundance, comes into your life, you can be assured luck, things going very, very well for you. You might have Sagittarius somewhere in your chart. There might be something about a Sagittarius. But let's just take more information and see. But it's such a, I want to say, delicious energy. It's such a delicious energy. You have been waiting for this. And I feel a lot of you guys, you don't believe. Yeah, you might be a little bit like, is this really for me? Do I dare to move up? The universe is like, hey, you have been waiting for this for a long time. We have been waiting for you to make the steps. I heard someone say, show yourself exactly who you are. Show this calmness that you have. The mother or the fatherly energy. You can be a male and still have a motherly energy. You mother people. You give people comfort. You nourish people with the way that you are. Beautiful. Oh, so much healing. Your wishes are coming true. I mean, what else do you want? Step out of the minds. Oh, wow, Cancer. Damn, yeah. You're looking into the future. You're leaving behind the ego, the mind clutter, the people who's been doubting you. Obviously, there can be something about Aquarius as well. And Leo. Why is this Leo season brings a lot of magic because you're really taking the steps now. You're really taking the steps. There's so much self-confidence. There's so much clarity here. You don't even care if people don't approve of your wishes. There's so many solutions coming from this. Yeah. It's money luck. I mean, again, these two cards is luck in money. You can't ignore that you have that double. Plus this, the world, I mean, wow. Everything begins to pay off here in the long term. You might even be guided to open up your own business, a new business. You're destined for something here. You're destined to be with someone, maybe even. And I feel that is what you are realizing. You don't need to be around bullies. You don't need to be around people who don't believe in you, people who put mind clutter upon you. There's equal energy here. You're stepping into a brand new world. It doesn't get better than this. It's achievement, it's travel, it's a sense of being. High sense of being. I want to say congratulations already now. I'm so excited to see what else you can get. I'm just fixing my bracelet because these tiny things, they are making a noise when I hit the table. But you can be proud of how far you have come. And I really think that you realize that. You realize where you want to go. You're not holding yourself back anymore. I feel that spirit, your higher self, has been blowing in this wind for the longest time, guiding you in the right direction. You have heard the calling for this change. And, you know, maybe some of you guys need still to change your mind about something. If there is someone who's bullying you, if there's bullying in a work situation, do you want to stay in that? Whatever this is, are you bullying yourself? Because we are very good at that, but we don't notice it because we do it, you know, not secretly, but, you know, when we look ourselves in the mirror and we are like, oh my God, you're disgusting. That is bullying ourselves, and we need to stop that. Regardless of what this change is, you can expect it to be brilliant. There's going to be a lot of communication, clear communication. You are understood. Other people really get you. They really understand you. Your ideas are solid. And this shift that you have been hearing for a long time is your higher self pushing you out here. It's very, very beautiful. What else can we get with that? Yeah, you have manifested that. Do you realize how brilliant this is? Woo! Out of anxiety, out of the misery, out of depression, out of whatever trap you have been holding yourself to, wow, whoa, how perfect is this? You can make that up. I almost get emotional with that. Oh my God. Okay, so you also have a Knight of Wands, and you have a Page of Cups. There is an offer coming your way now. If you are single and ready to mingle,
oh, that is so cheesy.
Oh, there's someone coming your way and you deserve this so much. You're going to blow people's mind with the new you. People are like, damn, what happens? So much creativity, so many. And this creativity that you show brings you offers. People want to work with you. People want to get to know you. People want to have your opinion. Milestones after milestones is going to be achieved now. Wow. I don't know why I wanted to shuffle more cards, because I don't think that you need anything else here. You're going to feel young. There might even be a younger person coming into your life, male or female. It might be someone with water in that chart, Pisces, Cancer, or Scorpio, or Sagittarius. The speed and action. I do feel, again, like I said in the beginning, the offers are coming in so fast that you doubt it because it's so fast. It's so unbelievable. That is what's happening, people. And your spirit guides are trying to make you aware of your amazing perspective on things, on life. And they are congratulating you with the healthy boundaries that you have put up. You're cleaning up the messy relationships, I feel. Especially with yourself, with your ego. You're hushing down the ego. You have control over your mind, your ego. Not the other way around. You believe in yourself. Because you Cancer people, you're very good at not believing in your dreams and desires and what you're doing. You don't see how brilliant you are. But we do. We see you. If there's someone that is draining you in your life right now, I feel it's a sign from your spirit guides that you need to let that person go. It might even be someone who is bullying you without that you realizing that it is bullying. It can be tiny things. It can be tiny niggles that this person puts on you. So just begin to put down healthy boundaries. Be patient. Be firm. because it might be very, very, very old habits that you are changing here. But I don't think it's going to be hard for you to figure out what it is, not with the other cards. But let's see what your spirit guides. Old habits. Yeah. The old way of you thinking that things are a trick of people out to get you. That could be for some of you. Okay, what happened here? I felt there was a card that was... But no. Okay, we try again. There's balance. There's a give and take. I do feel someone is actually... Yeah, you have been hurt in the past. Like, you have given so much, but then you didn't receive anything back. Affection, help, whatever, you know. A simple thank you. So that might be something that's still stuck with you, that you are afraid that people would disappear out of your life, or you're afraid that you're not receiving anything back. It might be something that's dated back to your childhood. It might be something with a father figure, old relationship. It could be an old money mindset. It could be something around the Aries or Taurus. The Taurus energy did come out in the beginning. Yeah. So there might have been someone, or there might be still someone who is untrustworthy. Someone who's greedy in your life. Someone who's taking and taking and taking. You're not receiving anything back. The purple color came up again. So again, that might be interesting with this, right? That might be a sign here. Like, maybe you see the purple color when you're around this person, and it's like a hint for you. Because maybe for some of you guys, you don't really understand who this person is yet. It might be someone who's very good at hiding, or someone who's very good at manipulating. But as someone who's corrupt here, someone who is nasty, might even be involved in fraud, gambling. Someone who just wants to win at any cost. A stealer, I heard. It might even be someone, now that you are, you know, really receiving all the, well, the fame, the money, the... I want to use the Danish word of Maximhill. What is that in English? Attention. Yeah, the attention is on you. And someone suddenly shows their true colors. Very interesting with the purple. So they suddenly get greedy because they want to have a big part of the pie. Like, yeah, they have been living in the shadows. They have been feeding on you in a way, like on your gentleness, your kindness. And suddenly they see that you're just moving so much forward that you might not need them anymore. And that makes them angry in a way. So just pay attention to that. I don't think it's any red flags. But again, there is a reason why your spirit guides decide to give you that message. I heard someone say it is on purpose. Yeah. But let's just give you the last card. So for whatever happens in the here and now. Oh, what do we have here? The Seven of Wands. Okay. And let's take a card for this unexpected energy. This, maybe even this person. Well, there's two cards that popped up. So we have the Moon reversed and we have the Page of Swords reversed. Interesting, now that you have the Page of Cups upright. So maybe there is someone that you have been letting go of who gave you anxiety. Someone who doesn't want you to be happy. Maybe it's a Pisces, because then again, the Moon. Well, I'm going to look into it, but let's just take the last one from your spirit guides. So, is it the Wheel? The Wheel. Must be the Wheel of Fortune, right? I'm just going to double check in the book, but I think it's the Wheel of Fortune. Might be an X coming back here. Knight of Wands. You have the Knight of Wands two times. I think someone doesn't like that you're moving forward. Someone doesn't like that there's someone new coming in. Someone with way more passion. Someone doesn't like that. I feel someone doesn't like that.
is this?
Okay, business call. So I am back hours later and we're going to continue. But with the Seven of Wands reversed, you are bagging out of something which is the healthiest and best option for you. You're bagging out of a challenge. You're bagging out of something that was very toxic. For some of you, if you have felt like giving up, this is a sign for you not to. Because that, again, you're stepping into magic. Sometimes we give up right before something magical is appearing. So that is a big message for you. With the Page of Swords, I do feel that there has been someone who's been talking shit behind your back. Maybe even someone who was very cold, but when they needed something, they got back into your life. But it's also a message for you not to drag the past into the future. Very important. You have so many magical new tools right now that you don't need to ask permission from the past. You don't need to step into the past to bring in the new. Things are becoming very, very clear for you now. Very, very clear. There might be a person who's making it clear for you or helping you. You are unveiling secrets, not blocking your intuition anymore. So if there is an ex coming back into your life, just follow your guidance. Don't step into drama. Listen to intuition, because you are going in the right direction. Pay attention to someone who's coming in to help you here. Very, very important. But I feel that this is going to be it for you. I hope it resonated. Let me know in a comment below. If you are in need of a private reading, healing session, or removal of blocks, all information is down below. Remember to like and subscribe and become a part of this family. And I'll see you in my next video. Bye!